Your car insurance payments may be on the rise, and it may have nothing to do with your driving.
12 News' Kent Wainscott has been investigating the controversial way insurance companies determine your risk on the road. He joins us now with a 12 News investigation.
A speeding ticket, a fender bender, maybe a teenage driver at home, all things that can drive up your auto insurance premium. But there's another factor determining how much you pay, one you may have never considered.
No two drivers and no two insurance policies are the same, but most drivers figure they know what's important to their insurance company.
How many accidents you may have had and your age.
I suppose your driving record would probably be one.
I think it should be basically your driving record.
Well, your road record is a factor, but so is your credit record. Nearly every insurance company in Wisconsin now uses credit scores to set premiums, some putting as much or more weight on credit history than on driving history.
If they put a lot of weight on your credit rating, I don't think that's fair.
I don't think it's fair. No.
I was shocked when I first found out about this.
State Senator Jeff Plaley has co-sponsored a bill to ban the practice because he says on the surface it doesn't seem to make sense.
I just don't see the correlation between, you know, making your payments to Best Buy and your ability to safely operate an automobile.
But the insurance industry says there is a link. In fact, they say state and federal studies have consistently found a strong correlation between credit scores and the risk of loss. And Milwaukee attorney and credit expert Amy Solberg says it's true.
There have been several studies done that demonstrate a high, very, very high correlation between your credit score and your likelihood to file a claim. And it correlates both with the number of claims and with the dollar amount of those claims.
And that may be the key, that the risk the companies are assessing is not the risk of getting into an accident, it's the risk of filing a claim. And for that, they claim, credit scores can help predict the future. The Wisconsin Insurance Alliance says credit scoring means lower rates for more than 60% of consumers. But the practice is not good news for everyone.
The people that are going to be most affected by it are those who have not been responsible users of credit or who may have inaccuracies on their credit report.
This is just basic fairness. This is basic fairness. Whether or not, you know, somebody missed a credit card payment or is back on their house payment, you know, should not be a deciding factor in what they pay on their monthly car insurance. It's just they're apples and grapefruit. They're not related.
The bill to ban the practice is still pending in the state legislature, and we should point out it addresses not only using credit scores for your car insurance premium, but for your homeowner's insurance as well. Now, Wisconsin actually does regulate how insurance companies use credit scores, prohibiting them from making decisions based solely on credit. But insurers are allowed to use credit as a factor in setting rates. Meanwhile, the Community Insurance Information Center says this is a good reason to regularly check your credit report. Make sure that there are no mistakes there so you're not paying more than you have to, and you can do that for free. We have a link on our website, WISN.com.
Okay, what about people with good credit? Would they pay more if companies are eventually banned from using credit scores?
Yeah, it's very possible that that's the case. If a company relies heavily on credit scores, the consumer with good credit is probably paying a lower rate right now, and yeah, if they're not allowed to use that as a factor, then they can expect to pay more.
Oh my goodness. All right. Thank you, Ken.
Sure.